Hello, it's your teacher, Anna Otto, here to round out Module 1 by going over some of the major theories of human development that we'll encounter this semester. First theorist we'll talk about is Erik Erikson and his psychosocial theory of development. Erikson is a stage theorist, so he feels that there are distinct developmental tasks in each of the relevant age periods, starting in the first year with trust versus mistrust, and whether or not a child develops a general sense of trust by having his or her basic needs met in the toddler years, 1 to 3. Working on autonomy versus shame and doubt, autonomy being about that independence and accomplishing tasks on one's own. 3 to 6, the period of initiative versus guilt, initiative about trying new things, jumping into new activities. 7 to 11, middle childhood, the period of industry versus inferiority, industry having to do with success and those tasks that are deemed relevant in society and building self-confidence. 12 to 18, the preteen and teen years, is the period of identity versus role confusion. Kids are working to figure out who they are, what's important to them, how they fit into the bigger picture of society. Early adulthood, 19 to 29, intimacy versus isolation, about building relationships with others and ultimately building romantic relationships. 30 to 64, middle adulthood, the period of generativity versus stagnation, generativity about giving to and guiding the next generation, so looking to contribute to society and to one's family. And then finally, 65 and over, late adulthood, integrity versus despair, wrapping up one's life story and preparing for the end of one's life. Another stage theorist is Piaget, and Piaget has a four-stage theory of cognitive development, starting in infancy toddlerhood with sensory motor stage, where the world is experienced through the senses and motor actions. 2 to 6, early childhood, the pre-operational stage, when kids use words and images to think about, represent, interact with the world, but they're not yet logical. 7 to 11, middle childhood, the concrete operational stage when kids are able to understand the world that they can experience, the world that they're a part of. They're able to start thinking, approaching things more logically, and performing simple arithmetic operations. And then finally, in adolescence, 12 and up, the formal operational stage where kids start using formal operations and start to think about the world abstractly. Since we're looking at lifespan development, we'll also be introduced to what's called post-formal thought, or those who follow along with Piaget, but then continue to talk about ways that cognition changes and develops into the adult years. Behaviorism and social learning are our first non-stage theories. If you've ever heard about Pavlov and his dogs, where he rang a bell and introduced food to create salivation in the dogs, that's classical conditioning. If you've heard about Skinner and his rats pushing levers to get treats and then providing either reinforcement or punishment to encourage or discourage that's operant conditioning. Classical conditioning and operant conditioning are forms of behaviorism. And then, if you've heard of imitation, modeling, that's social learning, often connected with the name Bandura as a theorist. Information processing is an approach to understanding cognitive development, whereby cognitive scientists study how individuals perceive, analyze, manipulate, use, and remember information. The idea is that we just improve our skills. We don't have new skills per se. If you've ever heard of the brain likened to a computer, then that's likely information processing. So we know inputs, we know outputs, we try to determine what happens in between. Vygotsky, and his sociocultural theory of development really focuses on the influence of culture and social interaction on development. He believes that it's dialogues between children and more expert members of society, either adults or more experienced children, that is the main mechanism for learning. Yuri Brockmanbrenner gives us the ecological systems theory, sometimes also referred to more currently as the bioecological systems, looking at the child at the center of this nested system of the environment and influences. So the most immediate environment being the microsystem, or those things that the child is directly a part of, going out to the least direct, the macrosystem, where the child is only indirectly influenced, in between the mesosystem and the exosystem, and then moving through time, looking at the chronosystem. Final theory, the developmental cognitive neuroscience, comes out of the surge in technologies such as fMRIs from the 1990s and continuing through current times, where scientists are actively working to map the brain to behavior and development.